ndinabana musanvu mpega no no musada ndina yaye tabawo bulungi ebisinga nizembi ekolera tane ralikizanga ngere ndale numa buli mwaka aye kati bwena funa echaji era ntereka ku nakumira endala.
So what we've seen is farmers that lost previously 30 to 40% of their harvest be able to reduce their losses to less than 2%. And they're able to do that with very simple technology and effective training. And the two of those combined enable the farmers themselves to really take control of their own futures for themselves and for their families.
We advise farmers, they should not sell their grain when they have just harvested, because when they just harvest, the prices go low. But after some months, after harvest, they will go on rising.
If we are to assist our farmers transition from subsistence to market-oriented approach, we need to help them save what they're producing. For this to be sustainable, we've got to bring other actors, especially the private sector.
We need a heavy and healthy inclusion of the private sector so that the value chains, the supply chains are developed naturally, the prices are set naturally, and that this has the ability or this has the capacity that a country itself and the private sector within it has the capacity for it to expand to millions and millions of farmers.
Kwa robe gua mko ndalo pele lo mino dula ina ngwele gini yo tria me prane ye itoma ni che ngomo ya kata ra ni che ngomo na pe ke tata mere ngon ne de lia na tromba lia lo ke nyen ka mo ma ele mna ba chumbi nga kidiko inga ne mare gua to na ke pak pak ko kana pak pak ko kana to geu ma kor kor na lo to ma tenik ni lo me kuam ye de ata to tai ko ni odwa nga data ko dik mu ji neta eta ta mi ki ni aji ke te ola ti peria ati ndiri anga ki mu e bi te ngolo lo et e bi te ngolo ramet e bi te ngolo ke nga da et e joak e pener bo cha bon bereng ni mo rena gi ne ra ki mu ji ngena.
Oh, it is very important. And if farmers are really sensitized well and understand the importance of being food secured, this food can really make sustain them up to the next year without disturbing people.
Ninaenda shikuta watoto wana baada ya kutia kwenye stoa watoto wanakuwa na afya nzuri. Utenda fika wakati mimea itaingia juu inakuwa na bei kubwa unaujisha unapata faida kuliko ule mwenye aliujisha mbele. Kitu ya kwanza ambao nilifaidika chuma kusaga mahindi.
We are seeing refugees getting involved in business, starting up small businesses because at least they have capital.
Nakuwa napata pesa kidogo. Nilipata saluni, nimenunua mbuzi, niko na mbuzi mbili, niko na nguruwe mbili kutoka kwa sai.
It is a very big improvement. To us it is a very positive trend as far as we are moving towards self-sufficient.
While we didn't quite expect it when we began, the expansion of the program out of traditional smallholder farmers into refugee livelihoods, as well as into our safety net programs in Karamoja, have given us the opportunity to see farmers begin to leapfrog, do a development leapfrog, similar to mobile phones, skipping over fixed lines and immediately going to mobile phones as a technology leapfrog. We're seeing a development leapfrog where farmers, instead of moving them into subsistence, have the potential to work themselves immediately into a surplus production where they become part of the market. We began with traditional smallholder farmers in the training programs, but soon afterwards learned that many schoolmasters, hundreds of them, had actually learned about the program, came for the training, and then purchased hermetic storage. So now you have thousands of school children across Uganda who are benefiting from cleaner, fresher, and better preserved grain throughout the school year.
We have had continuity and we have had enough of food supply in our schools. Children no longer get out of school to go and look for something to eat. It has been good for them because they are in school now.
The results have been amazing, but I know this is just the beginning. We're barely scratching the surface.
It's an enormous opportunity. If you look at 80% of the sub-Saharan population that actually are smallholder farmers, and all of them are facing losses of 30 to 40%, the inclusion of hermetic or airtight storage that eliminates post-harvest losses would completely change the game for food security and for livelihoods on the entire continent.